Hi students, today we are discussing about the unit name is genetics and the topic name is principles of inheritance and variations. Class number 10. First, genetics. Genetics means it is a branch of biology. Is a branch of biology and it deals with the study of inheritance. Study of inheritance and variations. This branch deals with the study of inheritance and variation is called as genetics. First, we are discussing about inheritance or heredity. Inheritance means the characters passed on from parents to offsprings through genes is called as inheritance. Characters passed from parents to offsprings is called as inheritance or heredity through genes. This is the inheritance or heredity. Next, variations. Variations are mutations. Offsprings differ from the parents in some characters. These are called as variations. Offsprings differ from parents offsprings differ from parents in some characters. Is called as variation. Next, another one, mutation. Mutations are the sudden changes that occurs in the organism and it leads to changes in the physical appearance. These are called as mutations or also variations. This is the genetics, a branch of biology that deals with the study of inheritance. Inheritance means characters passed from parents to offsprings through genes is called inheritance or heredity. Next, variations means offsprings differ from parents in some characters is called variations. Mutations are the sudden changes that occurs in the organism and it leads to the change in the physical appearance of organism. These changes are also called as mutations. Mutations were first discovered by Hugo de Vries. Mutations discovered by Hugo de Vries. Hugo de Vries in Enothera lamarckiana, evening primrose. Enothera lamarckiana, evening primrose plant. Next, Mendel, Gregor Johann Mendel. Mendel conducting hybridization experiments. Hybridization experiments on garden pea plant or pea plant. Garden pea plant for 7 years. He conducting hybridization experiments on garden pea plant for 7 years and he introduced the laws of inheritance. Hence, Mendel is regarded as the father of genetics. Mendel introduced loss of inheritance. Hence he is regarded as the father of genetics. Next, Mendel choosing 14 traits or 14 characters. These are also called as contrasting traits. Mendel using 14 contrasting traits generally appears in 7 pages. 7 pages of contrasting characters are used in garden pea plant, and he conducting the hybridization experiments in 7 years, and he also introduced the laws of inheritance. Hence Mendel is regarded as the father of genetics. The 7 contrasting characters, 7 pages of contrasting characters, they are first one serial number, second one character, and third one contrasting characters or contrasting traits. Serial number 1, size of the plant, they may be tall or dwarf. This is the 1 contrasting character, size of the plant. Plant size is tall. One plant is tall. That a tall plant crossed with a dwarf plant. And second one, flower color, violet. A violet colored flower is crossed with white colored flower. This is the second contrasting trait. And third one is flower position. Flower position is axial or terminal. Axial flower containing plant is crossed with terminal flower containing plant. This is the third contrasting trait. And fourth one, pod shape. Pod shape, inflated or constricted. This is the fourth contrasting trait. The shape of the pod, pod shape is inflated or constricted. And fifth one, pod color. Green or yellow. This is the fifth contrasting character. Pod color is green or yellow. And the sixth one, seed shape. Shape of the seed, round or wrinkled. A round seeded plant is crossed with a wrinkled seeded plant. This is the sixth contrasting trait. And last, seventh one, seed color. Yellow or green. Yellow seeded plant is crossed with green seeded plant. These are the 7 pairs of contrasting characters or 14 contrasting traits. Mendel used the 14 characters or 14 contrasting traits and conducting hybridization experiments in 7 years. The plant name is garden pea plant and introduced the laws of inheritance. He is regarded as the father of genetics. Now I am discussing about the some definitions. Homozygous, heterozygous, next to phenotype, genotype, dominant character and a recessive character. First one is homozygous character or homozygous condition. Homozygous means an individual having two similar kinds of alleles in a alleles for a single gene is called as homozygous. An individual having similar kinds of alleles in a for a single character is called as homozygous. The character which can be expressed by a gene and a gene having two similar alleles or an individual having similar kinds of alleles for a single character, for the expression of single character, is called as homozygous. For example, the tallness character can be expressed by capital T. Tallness character can be expressed with capital T. Capital T means tall. The gene having two similar kinds of alleles. Capital T is a one allele and another capital T is a another allele. Hence, for the expression of tallness character, one character, they can be expressed with similar kinds of alleles present in a organism is called as homozygous condition. Capital T. And dwarfness character, another example, dwarf character, they can be expressed with small t. Small t means a dwarf. They do not describe with dd. They can be expressed with small t. So dominant character, recessive character also. Capital T is a dominant character and small t is a recessive character. This is the homozygous condition. An individual having similar kinds of alleles for a single character is called homozygous. Next, a homozygous parent produces only one gamete produced from the homozygous parent. Next, heterozygous means an individual having two different kinds of alleles for the expression of a single character is called as heterozygous. An individual having two different alleles for a single character, for the expression of single character, an individual having two different alleles, this condition is called heterozygous condition. A heterozygous tall, example, heterozygous tall plant can be expressed with capital T, small t, due to the presence of two different alleles. Capital T allele expresses the tallness character and small t allele express the dwarfness character. Both capital T and small t alleles are present in a single gene and expresses only one character. Hence the condition is called heterozygous condition. A heterozygous individual produces two gametes, that is capital T gamete and small t gamete, but the homozygous parent produces only one gamete. This is the heterozygous condition. Next, 2 marks important bit. Phenotype, explain the phenotype and xenotype. Phenotype means physical or external appearance of a trait. Physical appearance of a trait is called phenotype. Physical or external appearance. Physical appearance of a trait is called as phenotype. 2 marks important bit. Next, genotype. Genetic makeup of an individual. Genetic makeup of an individual. Genetic makeup of an individual is called as genotype. Next, dominant character. Dominant character means the character which is expressed in both phenotypic and genotypic condition is called as dominant character, or the character which is expressed in the F1 generation. The character which is expressed in F1 generation is called as dominant character, or the character which is expressed in both homozygous condition and heterozygous condition, the character is also called as dominant character. For example, the tallness character, can be expressed in both homozygous condition. Capital T, it expresses tallness character. Next, another one, capital T, small t, it is in heterozygous condition. This heterozygous condition also expresses tallness character. Hence, the character due to the presence of capital T allele or capital T gamete, it expresses the tallness character. Hence, the character which is expressed in both homozygous condition and heterozygous condition is called as dominant character, or the character which is expressed in the F1 generation is called dominant character. Next one, recessive character. The character which is expressed only in homozygous condition is called recessive character. Recessive means the character which expressed only in homozygous condition is called as recessive character, or the character which is unexpressed in the F1 generation and expressed in the F2 generation, first filial generation and second filial generation, is called as recessive character. These are the some important definitions in genetics. Homozygous means an individual having similar kinds of alleles for a single character is called homozygous, and it produces a single gamete. Heterozygous condition means an individual having two different alleles for a single character is called heterozygous, and it produces two gametes. Next, phenotype means physical appearance or external appearance of a trait is called phenotype. Genetic makeup of an individual is called genotype. Dominant means the character which is expressed in the homozygous and heterozygous conditions is called dominant character, or the character which is expressed in the first filial generation is called dominant character. Next, second one, recessive character. The character which is expressed only in homozygous condition is called recessive character, or which is expressed in the F2 generation is called recessive character.